My dear children, how are you? I hope you are fine. You are going to write your half-yearly examination. Okay. First of all, I wish you children all the best. Give your best in your examination. Okay. See here, children. This is your exam question. Chapter 4, Chapter 6, Chapter 10, 11, and 13. Parts and whole, B by multiple, and B your factor. 10, 30, 100. Area and its boundary, ways to multiply and divide. These are the chapters you have to revise for your half-yearly examination. Okay, now see here, this is your question pattern. Choose comes for 10 marks and fill-ups 5 marks, 3 marks, 15 marks. You have choice question. Among them, you have to answer only for 5 questions. So, 5 into 3, 15. Also, you have choice in 5 marks also. Among them, you have to answer only for 4 questions. So 4 into 5, 20 marks. So totally 20 plus 5, 25, here 25, 50 marks you are going to write for half yearly examination. Okay. First we are going to revise the chapter parts and wholes. In the chapter parts and wholes we are discussing about the fractions. Okay. What is mean by fraction? Fraction is a part of your whole. The whole may be either a single object or a collection of objects. Okay. And also a fraction contains a numerator and denominator. You know this thing already. Okay. Now the question is, see this diagram. Now we have to write the fraction for shared portion. How do you write the fraction for shared portion? First of all, in the denominator you have to write the total parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Totally how many parts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parts. So totally we have 5 parts. So you have to write always total parts in the denominator. And see the question. They are asking fraction for shared portion. Shared portions means you have to count the shared parts. How many parts are shared? 1, 2. So you have to write 2. So fraction for shared portion is 2 by 5. Do you understand? See the next one. Fraction for unshaded portion. Okay. How can you write the fraction for unshaded portion? As here we are going to write here also. First you have to write the total parts in the denominator. We have totally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parts totally in there. And in the numerator you have to count the unshaded parts. Okay. How many parts are unshaded? 1, 2, 3. These 3 parts are not shaded. So you have to write it as 3 by 5. Thus, fraction for shared portion is 2 by 5. Fraction for unshared portion is 3 by 5. You understand? And also we have to write the fraction for this fraction names. Okay, definitely you have the 1 mark based on this. Okay, so listen carefully. What is the fraction for 3, 4? You have to write the number 3 on the numerator. And for 4th, you have to write the number 4 as a denominator. So your answer is 3 by 4. What is the fraction for 1/6? You have to write the number 1 as the numerator and 6 as the denominator. So 1 by 6. So what is the fraction for 2/5? So you have to write the 2 as a numerator and 5th. Further, you have to write 5 as the denominator. Similarly, 1/3. So you have to write the number 1 as the numerator. Further, you have to write 3 as the denominator. So your answer is 1 by 3. Okay. So 3/4, 3 by 4. 1/6, 1 by 6. 2/5, 2 by 5. 1/3, 1 by 3. Do you understand, children? Okay. Next, we are going to see types of fractions. Very, very important. Definitely, you all have one more based on this. Okay. What is mean by proper fraction? Based on the values of numerator and denominator, we are classifying as proper fraction, improper fraction, mixed fraction, like that. Okay. What is mean by proper fraction? If the value of numerator is less than denominator, such fractions are said to be proper fraction. For example, 4 by 7. See here, 4 is the numerator, 7 is the denominator. See, 4 is less than 7. Okay. If the numerator is smaller than its denominator, see here, if the numerator is smaller than its denominator, such fractions are said to be proper fraction. See here, 1 by 3. See, 1 is smaller than 3. So these are the examples for proper fraction. Then what is the improper fraction? If the numerator is greater than its denominator, such fractions are said to be improper fractions. See here, 7 by 2. See, 7 is the numerator, 2 is the denominator. See, 7 is greater than its denominator. Similarly, 5 by 3, see, the numerator is greater than its denominator. So such fractions are said to be improper fraction. Do you understand? See, what is the next one? Mixed fraction. Mixed fraction is a combination of a whole number and a proper fraction. So 2 1 by 4 is a dash fraction, mixed fraction. Do you understand? 3 1 by 6. 3 1 by 6 is a dash fraction, mixed fraction. See, it is a combination of a whole number as well as a proper fraction. Okay. Next, we are going to see like fractions. What is meant by like fractions? If the given fractions have the same denominator, see here 3 by 5, 2 by 5, 1 by 5, 7 by 5. See, all the denominators are same. See, here also 5, here also 5, here also 5, here also 4. So we are calling this fraction as like fraction. So like fractions means same denominator. Remember this proverb, children. Like fractions means same denominator. Like fractions means same denominator. Suppose if the denominators are different with each other, suppose 15, 25, 75, 5. See, all the denominators are different with each other. Here we have 15, 25, 75, 5. So at this situation, we call this fraction as unlike fraction. Suppose if the denominators are same means we can call fraction as like fractions. If the denominators are different with each other means we can call it as a unlike fraction. So unlike fraction means different denominator. We understand, children? Okay. You have to practice all the sums in your class of and max homework in your rough note. Okay. Next, we are going to see the problem. Write the 3 equivalent fractions of 3 by 8. Okay, already you know this sum. How can you find the equivalent fractions for given fraction? By multiplying the numerator and denominator by the same number. So first of all, you have to write the fraction like this, 3 by 8. The next step, you have to write like this, 3 into 8 into. First, you have to choose 2 or any number. Now you are choosing the number 2. So you have to multiply denominator as well as the numerator by the 2. So 3 2 are 6, 8 2 are 16. Next, again you have to write 3 by 8 equal to 3 into 8. So now we are choosing the number 3. So 3. Multiply both the numerator and denominator with the same number. 3 3 are 9, 8 3 are 24. Next, I am choosing the number 5. So 3 into 5, you may also choose 4, children. 3 into 5 15, 18 into 5 14. The question, they are asking only the 3 equivalent fractions. So I am going to stop counting this. Now we are going to write the equivalent fractions of 3 by 8. Now can you write? First you have to write the given fraction, 3 by 8, which is equal to 6 by 16, which is equal to 9 by 24, which is equal to 15 by 14. Do you understand, children? Next, children, we are going to revise the chapter number 6. In this chapter, what are the concepts we have discussed? Multiples of a number, factors of a number, common multiples of given numbers, and also addition of large numbers, and how to multiply the numbers ending with 0. Now we are going to revise this concept. Okay. How do you write the multiples of a given number? See here. Here I have written the first 10 multiples of 7. What are the first 10 multiples of 11? First 10 multiples of 11, 22, 33, 44, 55, 66, 77, 88, 99, 110. So this is the way you have to write the multiples of a given number. Okay. Next, we are going to discuss about factors. How do you write the factors of a given number? See here, first we are going to write the factors of a number 36. So in all the sum, first step is to find the factors of a number is, we have to write the given number as a product of 1. So 1 into 36, which is equal to 36. Next, you have to write the possible way of multiplying the given number. See here, 36 can be written as 2 into 18. So 18 into 36. Also, we can also write the 36 as 12 into 3. So 12 3 are 36. 3 2 are 6, 1 3 is 3. Similarly, 8 2 are 16. Remainder 1 1 3 is 2 plus 1 36. Next, 36 also written as the multiples of 4. 9 4 are 36. Also 6 6 are 36. So this is the all the possible way of writing the 36 as a product of some other number. See, 36 equal to 1 into 36, 2 into 18, 3 into 12, 4 into 9, 6 into 6. Thus, we have written all the possible ways. Now, we are going to write the factors of 36. Factors of 36 are, while you are writing the factors, you have to write in the ascending order. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. For 2, 6, you have to write only 1 times 6. Until 9, 12, 18, 36. So, these are the ways you have to write the factors of a given number. Okay, further you have to remember the multiplication table. So, first you have to read all the multiplication table up to 16. Okay. Next, we are going to write the common multiples for given two numbers. Write two common multiples of 3 and 5. Now, we are going to find the common multiples of 3 and 5. For that, first you have to write the multiples of 3. What are the multiples of 3? 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30. Just say the table and write the answer here. Similarly, what are the multiples of 5? 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 30, 40, 45, 50. Here I compared the first day multiples of 3. The question they are asking only the two common multiples. So you have to check whether there is a common number here and here. See here 15, here also we have the 15. Similarly, here we have the 13, here we have the 13. Thus, we have rounded the common multiples of 3 and 5. See, 15 is also a multiple of 3, 15 is also a multiple of 5. Similarly, 30 is the multiple of 3, 30 is multiple of 5. So, we can say common multiples of 3 and 5 are 15, 30. They are asked only 2 only. So, we have stopped up to this. See here, among the common multiples of 3 and 5, which is the first number 15. So, we can say 15 is the smallest common multiple of 3 and 5. See, listen children, you have one more based on this concept, okay? But which is the smallest common multiple of 2 and 3? 6. 6 is the smallest common multiple of 2 and 3. Similarly, 15 is the smallest common multiple of 3 and 5, okay? Next, we are going to see how to add large numbers. In the question paper, definitely you have the sum based on addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, okay? So, thorough these operation very well, okay? How can you add a large number? You know the addition very well, but how can you write the given number? See here we have a 2-digit, 3-digit and 5-digit, 6-digit number. While you are arranging the number for addition, first you have to write the number from one step. See here, 10 ways are just ones, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh. First you have to write 5 in the place of ones and 3 in the place of tens. Similarly, 173, you have to write the 3 in the place of ones, 7 in the place of tens and 1 in the place of hundreds. Similarly, see here, 47,632. You have to write the 2 in the place of ones, 3 in the place of tens and 6 in the place of 100 and 7 in the place of 1000 and 4 in the place of 10,000. Similarly, you have to write the next number also. So, this is the way you have to arrange the given numbers. And then you have to add the number. Okay, we add 5 plus 3. You have to use your fingers to count the digits. Okay, 5 plus 3 is 8. 8 plus 2 is 10. 10 plus 3 is 13. For 13, here you have to write the number 3. So, write 3 here and write 1 here as a remainder. Okay, next 7 plus 3 is 10. 10 plus 3 is 13, 30 plus 7 is 20, 20 plus 1 is 21. For 21, here you have to write the number which is on the right hand side, 1. And write 2 as the remainder here in the 100 space. Okay. Next, you have to add this. 1, 6 plus 1 is 7. For that, you have also add like this. 6 plus 4 is 10, 10 plus 1 is 11, it's your choice. 6 plus 1 is 7, 7 plus 4 is 11, 11 plus 2 is 13. Here you have to write the number 3 and write 1 here as the remainder. Next you have to add this 7 plus 3, 10, 10 plus 1, 11. So write 1 here and write 1 here as a remainder. 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 1, 7 and write 1 like this.
Here we have added all the numbers and we get the answer 171313. You have to place the comma like this after the first digit and the next two digit. How can you read this number 1,10,000, 10,000? So 1,78,313. Okay. Next we are going to do the sum multiplication of given numbers ending with 0. Since I have got this method, but in your unit test 2 paper I have seen many of you doing the ordinary method. Okay, you have to follow this method to number which are ending with 0. See here children, this is a very easy method and smart method. Okay, how can you multiply this number? See here 4,000, here 30. All the given two numbers are ending with 0. First you have to strike out the 0 by using the principle. Okay, next you have to multiply the remaining two numbers. 4, 3 is 12. Now you have to add the zeros which you have strike out. How many zeros you have strike out? 1, 2, 3, 4. So you have to add 4 zeros. 3 digit, 2 digit. Next you have to see the next sum 700 into 400. You have to strike out the zeros. So what are the remaining numbers? 7 and 4. 7 4 is 28. How many zeros you must take out? 4 zeros. Add the 4 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4. After the 3 digit and then 2 digit. You have to place the comma first 3 digit and the next you have the 2 digit. Okay. Next is the last one. Forget the zeros. 8 twos are 16. And how many zeros you forget? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You have to add 5 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3 digit, 2 digit. Okay, so this is the way you have to multiply the numbers ending with 0. Do you understand, children? We are going to revise the chapter number 10. In this chapter, we have seen the concept of units of length. What are the units of length? Kilometer, meter, centimeter, millimeter. Shortly, we have written kilometer as km and meter as m and centimeter as cm and millimeter as mm. Okay, these are the units of length. Among the units of length, which is the highest unit? Kilometer. And next, meter. And then, centimeter. And then, millimeter. So, smallest unit is millimeter. After that, which is the unit greater than millimeter? Centimeter. Next, meter. And then, kilometer. Okay. Next, we are going to see the conversion formula among these units. 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meter. 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. 1 centimeter equal to 10 millimeter. See here children, 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. Here, these are the units. Kilometer is converted into meter. Similarly, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter and 1 centimeter equal to 10 millimeter. In this chapter, we are discussing how to convert higher unit to lower unit. See here, while you are converting the any higher unit to lower unit, you have to use the operation multiplication. See here, kilometer, meter, centimeter, millimeter. Here we have arranged the units in the order of descending order. See here the highest unit, here the lowest unit. In order to convert the higher unit to the lower unit, you have to multiply the given value. See here, if you want to convert the given number from kilometer to millimeter, means meter, means you have to multiply the given value by 1000. Similarly, if you want to convert meter to centimeter, means you have to multiply the given value by 100. Similarly, if you want to convert the given value from centimeter to millimeter, means you have to multiply the given value by 10. Okay. Why we are writing the number 1000, 110 here? Because what is the conversion formula? 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meter. So in order to convert kilometer to meter, you have to multiply the given value by 1000. Similarly, meter to centimeter, you have to multiply the given value by 100. Similarly, centimeter to millimeter, you have to multiply the given value by 10. See the first sum, 720 kilometer. Here we are going to convert the value kilometer to meter. We know the conversion formula, 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meter. You have to write, definitely you have to write the formula in the test paper. Okay. So, 720 kilometer. Now we are going to convert this kilometer into meter. By conversion formula, we know that 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meters. So in order to convert kilometer to meter, we have to multiply the given value by 1000. How do you multiply the given two values, ending in 0 by further the zeros, and then multiply the remaining value. 72 into 1, 72. And then you have to add the zeros. How many zeros you have for that? 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. Now you have to add the 4 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. And then next, you have to place the 3 digit, 2 digit. Here you have to write the unit meter. Thus, you have converted 720 kilometers into meter. We understand how do you read this number? 1 steps, alright? 1000, 10,000, 7 lakh, 20,000 meter. Okay. Let's see the next sum, 32 meter. Here we are going to convert this meter into centimeter. What is the conversion formula? 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. To convert meter to centimeter, we have to multiply the value by 100. So 32 into 100. So what is the answer? 32. 1 into 2, 2. 1 3 is 3. Pocket the zeros and add the zeros here. So your answer is 3200 centimeter. Thus we have converted the value from meter to centimeter. Next see the sum, higher centimeter. Now we are going to convert the centimeter into millimeter. Okay, so here you have to write millimeter. We know the formula 1 centimeter equal to 10 millimeters. So you have to multiply the value by 10. 9 into 10, 90. So 90 millimeter. Thus 9 centimeter is converted into 90 as millimeter. Okay, so in order to convert higher unit to lower units, you have to multiply the given values as per the conversion formula. Okay, also children, in this chapter you have to practice the subtractions of you have to allow the subtraction of large numbers also. Okay, next we are going to see the chapter number 11. In this chapter we are mainly discussing about triangles. What is meant by triangle? Triangle is a simple closed figure which consists of three sides. Triangle has how many sides? Three sides. We can define the triangle as simple closed figure which have three sides and three vertices and three angles. Okay, it is a simple closed three sided figure. Okay, first we are going to see types of triangle. What are the types of triangles? Based on angles, we have three types, and based on sides, we have three types. Definitely, all the one mark based on this concept. Okay, what is meant by acute angle triangle? If all the angles are acute, then the triangle is said to be acute angle triangle. What is meant by acute angle? Lies between 0 and 90 degrees. Such angles are said to be acute angles. So, if all the angles of a triangle are acute, means then we can say the triangle as a acute angled triangle. Similarly, what is the way obtuse angled triangle? If any one of the axes of the triangle is obtuse, then the triangle is said to be obtuse angled triangle. What is the way obtuse? Angle greater than 90 degree and less than 180 degree. Such angles are said to be obtuse angles. Suppose if this angle is 120 degree, means we can call this triangle as obtuse angled triangle. Suppose if all the angles are acute, means we can call the triangle as an acute angle triangle. Okay. What is meant by right angle triangle? If any one of the angles of the triangle is right angle. What is meant by right angle? 90 degree. Such as see here, this triangle is 90 degree. This is the way you have to mention the right angle. Okay. So we can call this triangle as a right angle triangle. Why we are calling this? Because if any one of the angles of the triangle is 90 degree, then we can call the triangle as a right angle triangle. Next we are going to see triangles based on size, that is types of triangle based on size. First we are going to see equilateral triangle. What is mean by equilateral triangle? If all the sides of the triangle are equal, then we can say such type of triangle as a equilateral triangle. What is mean by isosceles triangle? If any two sides of a given triangle is equal, then we can call it as a isosceles triangle. And what is mean by scalene triangle? If all the sides of a triangle are in different measure, then we can call it as a scalene triangle. See here, equal to triangle. Observe the diagram children, all the sides are equal. Each sides measure 3 cm. So we can call this triangle as a equal to triangle. See here isosceles triangle. In this triangle we have the two sides which are in equal measure. Here also 4 cm, here also 4 cm. See the third side which is different from the measure of these two lengths. So we can call this triangle as a isosceles triangle. And what is mean by scalar triangle? Scalar triangle means all the three sides of a triangle are in different measures. See, this is 4 cm, this is 8 cm, this is 5 cm. So we can call this triangle as a scalar triangle. These are the three types based on measures of the sides of the triangle. And these are the three types based on the measures of the angles of a triangle. Okay. Next we are going to see how to find the area of the triangle. Before that, you have to remember the area of what is the shape. Square. And what is this shape? Rectangle. And this is triangle. Once again we are going to recall this formula. Definitely you have these 5 formula in your question paper. So don't forget to remember this. Okay. Definitely you have these 5 formulas. Okay. What is the first formula? Area of square. What is the formula of area of square? Yes. A square square. And what is the formula of area of rectangle? Length into breadth square units. While you are writing the area, you have to use the square units. For your writing perimeter, you have to write only units. Okay. What is the formula for area of triangle? Half into base into height square units. Shortly, we can say half B that square units. B stands for base and H stands for height. Okay. So, what is the formula for perimeter of square? What is the formula for perimeter of square? 4a units. And what is the formula for perimeter of rectangle? 2 into length plus breadth. That is 2 into l plus b units. Okay, now we are going to do a sum which is find the area of triangle whose base is 10 cm and height is 4 cm. In the solution part, first you have to write the base as b. B equal to 10 cm and height of h equal to 4 cm. And then you have to write the formula area of triangle. You have to write the spelling T R I A N G L E. Okay. Area of triangle equal to half B H units. Here you have to write square units. Okay. Half B H square units. What is the value of B? 10. You have to substitute the value of B instead of base. Okay, so 10, 1 by 2 into 10. What is the value of h? 4 into 4. Now you have to simplify this. For this simplification, you have to cancel any one of the value by 2. See here, now I am cancelling the 4 by 2. So 2 times. 1, 2 is 2, 2 to sub 4. So what is the value? 10 into 2. Here you have to write centimeter square. Because in the question they give the unit as centimeter. So you have to write centimeter. Since it is area, you have to use square unit. So centimeter square. 10 to sub 20. So 20 centimeter square. So area of the given triangle is 20 centimeter square. Next chapter we are going to revise chapter 3. In this chapter, definitely you have to practice the all divisions of and multiplications of normal. Multiplication of a given number by a 2-digit, 3-digit. Okay, definitely you have to practice that sums. Okay. Next, you have to remember this relation between divider, divisor, quotient and the remainder. This is the formula which gives the relation between these four terms. What is the relation? Divider equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Definitely all the one more based on this relation. Okay. What is the relation? Divider equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Okay. Let us see one problem. See here. Here we are going to divide the 2012 by 2. How can you divide? First you have to choose a number which is equal to or greater than a given divisor. This is the divisor, this is the divider, this is the place for quotient. Okay. First you have to choose a number. See here 2, 2 is equal to the divisor, so this is enough. Suppose if you have the number like this means, see here, here if you have the divisor 3 means, if you choose the 1 digit, it is not enough means, at that case you have to choose the 2 digit. Okay. Suppose if you have the divisor like this, and here you have the number like this means, at this time 1 digit is not enough, 2 digit is not enough, at that time you have to choose the 3 digits. So depending upon the value of the divisor, you have to choose whether you have to choose 1 digit or 2 digit or 3 digit. Here the chosen number is equal to the divisor. So you have to stop after this. So 2 comes in from table 1 times. Here you have to write the times. See here children, 1, 2 is 2. This is the answer for, and this is the table, and this is times. Here you have to write the values of times. So 1, 2 is 2. Here you have to put the subtract symbol, 2 minus 2, 0. Next you have to bring down the next digit 0. See here you have the divisor, but you have the next digit 0. This is not enough. So you have to bring the next digit. In order to bring out the 2 digit at the same step, you have to add 1 0 to the quotient. So here I am adding 1 0 to the quotient and bring down the next digit 1. See here our divisor is 2, but our value is only 1. It is not enough. Though we have 2 digit from the divided part, it is not enough. So we have to bring the next digit also. So we are bringing the next digit 2. So in a single step, we are bringing the 2 digit. Okay, for that you have to add 1 more 0 to the quotient. Okay, if you bring down 2 digit at a time, means you have to add 1 0. If you are bringing 2 digit at a same step, means you have to add 1 more 0. So you have to add 1 more 0. Now our number is 12. So 12 how many times in 2 table? 6 2s are 12. Here you have to write 6. So 6 2s are 12. So your remainder is 0. So here you have to write quotient equal to 1006 and remainder equal to 0. Practice all the addition sum, subtraction sum, multiplication sum, division sums. Okay. And how do you write your upper examination? You have to use blue ink pen to write your answers and use the sharpened pencil to draw the finishing lines and do your rough work by using pencil children and write the question number as in the question paper. Okay. Give your best in your examination. All the best. Okay. Thank you.